Hi, I'm Vince Whitfield, and we're here at the Katherine Johnson Computational Research Facility at NASA's Langley Research Center. We're about to cut the ribbon on this state-of-the-art facility, but before we do, let's take a sneak peek inside the building that will enable innovative research and development across all of NASA's mission areas. Let's take a look inside. This building, the third new structure built in the last 6 years as part of the center's revitalization plan, is named for Katherine G Johnson. For those watching who may not know, Ms. Johnson is a human computer, an amazing mathematician who calculated trajectories and played a key role in America's human spaceflight program, including the Apollo 11 moon landing. Featured in the lobby is a beautiful portrait of Ms. Johnson that was taken last year at nearby Fort Monroe by famous photographer Annie Leibovitz for a Vanity Fair magazine article. We also have items here that recognize Katherine and the other human computers, like an official proclamation from the Commonwealth of Virginia and a group achievement award from the NASA administrator. A little less than half of the space in this 37,000 square foot facility is dedicated to supporting the employees of the Office of the Chief Information Officer and those who will be contributing to and benefiting from the technologies that are housed here. Researchers from across the center will conduct a variety of computing projects here, including aerodynamic modeling, entry, descent and landing calculations, and computational fluid dynamics. The facility advances Langley's capabilities in modeling and simulation, big data, and analysis. Much of the work now performed in wind tunnels will one day be handled by powerful computers, such as those in the CRF. Now, let's go take a look at the guts of this high-tech facility. The data hall has a maximum capacity of nearly 200 racks. That's enough to store almost 4,000 systems here. You may have noticed the racks are mostly empty right now. About 1,200 servers will be moved from their current locations on center later this fall, allowing us to consolidate numerous server rooms and data centers from across Langley into this one data center here in the CRF. When all of the systems are moved, there will be about 13 miles of copper network cabling and 97 miles of fiber optic cable in the building. Now, I know it's loud in these rooms, and here's why. The electrical power plant that powers the IT functions of this building can supply 2.1 megawatts. That's enough to power a small town. Because of the importance of the information on the servers, the building is designed to withstand Category 3 hurricane conditions. There are generators that can run continuously even in the event of a power outage. And it's on track to receive LEED Silver certification from the US Green Building Council. The building is an energy saver, 33% more efficient than energy standards just a few years ago. So that concludes our quick look at this new building, a building whose capabilities and people will help to address NASA's future challenges. Speaking of the future, we have a special treat from the next generation of NASA employees from our Child Development Center here at NASA Langley.